We're going to take a look at some simple linear equations today. In solving linear equations, the first thing you want to do, or the first object you want to do, is find the variable term and get it along on one side of the equal sign. So here we have the x. To get it alone, we're going to do the opposite of what's ever being done to it. You see it's being added 2 to the x, so we're going to subtract 2. If we do it on one side, we do it on the other side. And x will be alone on this side, and it is equal to a. So that's the solution to the first equation. And then this is messed up. Okay, so for the second equation is a two-step equation. Why? Because we have two steps to do. We first have to get the variable term alone first, and then get the variable term, or variable alone. So what's being done to the variable term? We are subtracting 1, so we want to do the opposite and add 1 to both sides. So 2x is now equal to 12. The 1's are gone on that side. And now you want to divide both sides by 2. Since you're multiplying by 2 to the x, you want to divide by 2 to get that to go away. And what you're left with is the x on one side and 6 on the other side. So that's the solution to the two-step equation. Okay, so now this one is a multi-step equation. The reason it's multi-step is because we have x's on both sides of the equation. So what I like to do is get the x term on one side of the equation first, and then it's kind of finished off like the previous number 2 equation is done once your x's are together. So I always take the smaller value, so my x term will stay positive. This is a negative 2x. I'm just going to add the opposite to get it to go away on this side and have it added to this side. So now those are gone, and we have 5x's over here. Minus 2 equals 18. Now, since we brought the x's to this side, we want to bring the constants to the other side. So add 2 to both sides, and you're left with 5x equals 20. Now that our x term is alone, we can get rid of the coefficient in front of it. It's being multiplied by 5, so we divide by 5. And we are left with x equals 20 divided by 5, which is 4. So there you go. I hope that helps you review some equation solving tips, and I hope you enjoyed that, and thanks for watching.